so you wanted to hear my story, huh? It's been many years, soldier. Well, here it is.
Why do I have to carry the bag? It's so heavy.
Soldier, did I sign you up here so you could break down and cry? That's not what soldiers do in the military. You got that?
Sir, yes, sir.
All right, good. There should be some Charlie around here somewhere. So, Private Grand, where are you from? I see you're that reserved kind of guy. Well, me here is from Montgomery, Alabama. Ain't ever held a gun in my hand, not a single day. Man, it was good back there on the field. Drafted, or you guys volunteered?
I'm drafted.
Private, let's hear you got here.
Well, it was at home. My wife, Tammy, my kids. And I got a letter in the mail. Just saying, it's my turn.
Where are you from?
Miami, Florida.
And Florida. Here it's nice over there. Very tropical.
Very hot.
Just like Vietnam. Robin?
I volunteered.
So you volunteered, huh?
Yeah. My family, my mother, my father, and my brother all got killed in the war. And I figured that joining would be a good way to get revenge in a sense for what happened to them. But now I feel like, is it even worth it anymore? Is it worth dying to get revenge, or should I just live on and with their legacy? It's hard to tell.
Well said.
27 years I've been in war. 27 years, and you know what I learned?
No, sir.
You gotta go with your heart, boy. You really wanna get revenge on these enemies?
Do you get have revenge. Any regrets?
No regrets. Tattooed right on my neck. Private Cave, is it? Private Cave?
I don't want to be here. My parents forced me to volunteer.
Why would they do that?
I needed some self-discipline.
Self-discipline? Just gonna come back with terrible memories of friends dying and killing. It's not worth being here.
I don't have a choice.
How old are you?
17, straight out of high school.
Sucks.
Let's get out of here. Alright, boys. It's been a long day. And many long days are yet to come. 26 years I've been in this war. 26 years, and I don't plan on making it my last few years here. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna go shoot some bad guys. Shoot some bad guys, and then we're going home. Drinks on me.
Yeah!
Well said, General.
Well said.
Actually, if we make it back, I might just buy the whole damn bar. What do you guys think of that?
I think bar would be pretty good.
So let me tell you something here. On the other side of these trees is Saigon. Full of Charlie. We might just not make it out alive. At least a few of us, at least. So what do you say, boys?
So we go shoot some bad guys, like you say.
Once the sun rises up tomorrow morning, break of dawn, we head through those woods. What do you guys say?
Yes sir.
All right, let's get moving.
General's kind of cocky guy, huh?
Boys, that's a landmine. You run off into these trees, you might just step on one. I know there was some Charlie in here somewhere. Come back, boy. Time to say your goodbyes to your family. Saigon, boys. So, Private, you never gave me your full name.
Kenny Grand, sir.
Kenny Grand? Where are you from?
Seattle, Washington, sir.
Seattle, Washington? I once had a girlfriend from Seattle, Washington. Her name was Nancy. Nancy McButterfield. She broke my heart, alright.
General, you've told this story about 50 times.
Yeah, what about something new?
No, I'm gonna finish telling the stories I start telling. She was blonde, she had some beautiful blue eyes.
What do you know, boys? She was actually sterile.
Brother, no! Come on, Rabbit, wake up!
I think he's gone, General.
Bastards! You know what this means, boys? There's not gonna be an easy route to Saigon. We ain't gonna be able to go through these woods. It's gonna be filled silly old landmines. We're gonna have to take the long way, guys. Let's go, boys. Yeah. God Almighty. Is that a truck?
You know how to hotwire a vehicle like this?
Sure do. Jip, 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 boys.